Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for the podcast version of Trey's Variety Hour is brought to you by CashFly at CACHEFLY.com.
Welcome, everybody. This is going to be a very fun show. This is my first live show from New Zealand. I'm still not totally situated here yet, so I'm here with my friend Eden, who's kind of in the middle square right there. He might wave kindly in a Kiwi manner there at you guys. So anyway, we're using up his bandwidth to bring you this show live tonight. I've just returned from San Francisco, where we had this amazing photographers conference from Google+. Everybody that you see here was there at the conference, and we all had these amazing photo walks on the very first day, and I thought it'd be fun to bring all these photo walkers here, and we can share photos from our respective photo walks and get to know people and to see a lot of different work and just kind of relive last week for people that might have missed it. So this will be a very fun show in that way. So let's get started. Before we start showing photos from the photo walk, I'd like everyone to introduce themselves and say where they're from, and you guys can, as always, plug whatever you want to plug and mention whatever you want to mention. We'll go from left to right, and we'll start with Alex.
Hey everyone. My name is Alex Koloskov, and I'm Atlanta-based studio worm. You see, this is my habitat there. I'm a studio photographer, so I'm shooting all that kind of little studio stuff, little and not little. And sometime I just go outside if something interesting is going on, like it was in San Francisco a week ago.
So. Cool. It was great. It was great to meet you and your wife, and it was, you brought out your girls, and it was a whole family affair out in San Francisco. Did everyone have a good time?
Oh, yes. We all have a good time, and for girls, it was a cool time, too. We found a nice kids' club. And, yeah, we always travel, at least trying to travel the whole family, because it's hard to leave them more than, like, a day for me. So.
Well, it was great to meet you. I was out there with Curtis, who's sort of my my business manager, and he pulled me aside afterwards. He goes, man, you know that Alex, he's a really nice, good guy. And I bet everyone would say that after they met you. So anyway, just thanks for being so chill and so awesome.
Thank you, Trey. Thank you. It was a great pleasure for me to meet all of you guys. It was probably the first time when I met you.
All right, and next is the host of Twit Photo, who led a photo walk and was very active at the entire conference there, Catherine Hall.
Hey, everyone. I miss you guys. And I'm going to echo that Alex is awesome, and so is everyone else in the Hangout. So it's good to be here. I am, yes, Catherine Hall, and as you can see, I'm at Twit, so I'm also associated with the network like Trey. And I came out with my iPhone app on Friday. So top model release. I'm very
nice
excited.
Product placement there. I like it.
It was actually accidental. I put my laptop up and was like, oh. Sweet. But anyway, I'm very excited about the app. It's my first app, and it's already made my life a lot easier getting model releases. So thrilled about that. And photo walks were amazing. And it was just, more than anything, it was really just great to be in that community in real life, you know, instead of just on the online network. So it was a really, really good time. I'm glad,
well, cool.
I'm glad it's over. I wish there was more wine and cheese parties.
Yeah, that would have been good. But get your app ready, because maybe at the end of the show you can show people what it's like, because I think it's something that everybody could use and enjoy.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. And next is Dave Pfeffer, the producer of the show here. And Dave, let me first start out by, I've already privately apologized to you, but I will publicly apologize to you because, you know, we did that weird hangout on stage. You know, at the last second, they contacted me and said, oh, we're going to do a hangout in the middle of your on-stage performance. I was like, ah, okay. So, you know, it was really hard to get everyone involved. And I was hoping you would jump in and talk about how Google Plus has inspired you to become like a real photographer and all this stuff, but it was really hard to get everyone to talk, and it was weird. And anyway, I apologize. I was hoping you would jump in, though.
It is not a worry at all. So I was happy to be quiet.
Well, cool. I was glad you were there. You made me feel more comfy in that weird situation.
Well, so, I'm glad to be there for you, Trey.
Yeah. You're sort of like my comfort blanket when things go awry. I always know that you're there with your warm heart and your thick beard.
Makes me happy. Anytime, all right.
All right, so here's another warm-hearted guy. This is a Kiwi whose house that I am borrowing right now for the bandwidth. We're in the same room. It's very confusing. It causes audio problems, so I'm going to mute. He will unmute and introduce himself. Here we go.
Hi, everyone. My name's... Mute? Oh, sorry. There we go. Hi, everyone. My name's Eden Brackstone. I met Trey in 2010, October, so we had a get-together out at my parents' place at Gibson, and everything's been great since then. I'm a hobbyist photographer based here in Queenstown, and I sort of run a sort of weekly blog whenever I can afford the time to update what's going on in my life and release new photos, and I do HDR, astrophotography, all sorts of stuff. And I'll put a link in the chat if you'd like to check it out.
Cool. Thank you. Thank you, Eden. Okay, next is Karen Hutton. Hello, Karen.
Hello, Trey. I'm Karen Hutton, and I do voiceovers professionally at karenhutton.com and photography as well, lifeislightphotography.com. And I have a project opening next weekend in Portland that combines the two, plus music, plus a bunch of wonderful photographers in a multimedia extravaganza. So it's all going live on Friday at lilgalleries.com. I hope you're there. Bye.
Cool. That sounds like a good project.
It is a really good project.
And then here's another one, another gal to join us to class up the operation a little bit. This is Lotus Carroll.
Hi, everybody. I'm Lotus Carroll. I'm an Austin-based photographer and blogger. And I co-host a photography show every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Pacific with Thomas Hawk called Photo Talk Plus.
Excellent. And I know one of the sponsors for your show is Smug Mug, and you were able to go look at the headquarters, right?
Actually, I haven't gotten to go yet. That's another trip for me. So that's coming up later in the year. But Thomas went.
Ah, okay. I thought a big group of people went down there after the conference.
I think a lot of people did, but I wasn't able to.
Ah, okay,
yeah.
Cool.
So that's a future trip for me, actually, this year.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so people that watch y'all's show know that you're a big fan of Smug Mug. I am, too. I just posted a little – let me screen share really quick here. People might find this interesting. I did a little article about hold on a second here. I did an article about Smug Mug, kind of. Let me screen share and share this screen here. So this is a common question I get. It's about, like, how do you get your photos printed and stuff? Mm-hmm. And so I allow people to order my prints through Smug Mug, and you get this really nice kind of detailed report that shows whenever anyone buys anything. It's really cool because you kind of get to set your own price. Like in the case of these are someone bought four prints, and the price was about $900, and it has your cost, and of course the difference is your profit.
That's your cha-ching.
Yes, that's your little. They send you a little email that says cha-ching.
I love that. Fun.
Right. And so, anyway, you know, there's many different options for printing online, but this is what I use. It's what a lot of other people use. It's really cool, and all the customers are always super happy, and anyway, you know, like I said, Smug Mug doesn't sponsor the show or anything. I'm just happy to send a shout out to a good company like that.
They're fabulous.
Yeah, they're great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, RC, hello.
Hey, everybody. I don't know if you guys can come and hear me okay.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. So basically, my name is RC. I'm a content developer for Kelby Media Group basically design content, write podcasts, work on books, all sorts of different things, and just catching up from the craziness that was the Google Plus conference. Good time all around, though. It was pretty neat.
It was fun. I think I read on Google Plus that you went to go see Jeremy at the LifeFinder tour. What was that like?
It was pretty good. It was pretty, you know what, Jeremy's an amazingly, amazingly creative person. So it's to have him kind of share his work. It's always really, really hard to kind of share around Jeremy. I mean, Jeremy's just incredibly passionate, incredibly artistic, and he wanted me to come out and actually talk about the art behind what I do. So that was a little different for me. A lot of the times I spend, you know, teaching people technology and teaching people, you know, just tech stuff. So when people are asking me questions about the why of my image, it's a little different. But it was pretty cool. I enjoyed it. It was a good time.
You're muted, Trey.
Sorry, I was muted there. Yeah, Jeremy was great. I loved hearing his talk that night. It was, you know, they threw the Hangout thing at him sideways kind of last minute, too. And it was really funny because he was showing all these really inspirational, awesome, creative things that he did, right? And then it was, you know, and then he would kind of hand it over to the Hangout, and they wouldn't even have that much to say because he had just, like, blown everybody away. Well, this amazing stuff. You know, it's kind of like saying, oh, I was Luke Skywalker in Star Wars. Have you guys done anything like that? I'm like, no. No, we haven't done anything like that, Jeremy. But yeah, it was cool, though.
Jeremy's one of those few people that it's really hard to present next to him or near him. Just, I mean, and he's, the good part about it is that he's probably one of the most unassuming and, you know, genuinely caring individuals that's out there. And it's great, but it's just, yeah, it's very humbling to present near him.
He was preparing for his talk when we were doing, I do a show on Google Plus called Life Through the Lens, and we were actually doing a show that night while he was sitting over in the side of the room preparing for that talk. And so there's a couple of the gals on the show that just, like, have this big heartthrob for him. So I was like, are you daring me? And they're like, sure, go do it. And I said, Jeremy, would you like to say hello to our audience and to Life Through the Lens? He comes over, sticks his face in here and says, hi, how you guys doing? He was so sweet. He didn't have to do that, but he was a doll for doing it. So thank you, Jeremy. I appreciate it.
Yeah, he's
that's
a cutie.
Cool.
He's yeah, a good guy. He's a good, good guy.
So, okay, let's get started. We didn't really come into this prepared in any particular order. RC, do you have some pictures you might like to share from your photo walk? I got to hear a little bit about some of the stories while we were there, but I think everyone else would like to hear and see some photos from people on your photo walk and that sort of thing. Do you have some stuff to share with us?
Yeah, I've got a couple here that we can actually share. I'm going to go ahead and do this here. I'm just going to go ahead and share. I'll share my desktop real quick.
Cool.
This. Oh. And now let's see. I have some pictures here. So three images that kind of stood out for me. First image, right? So this was Eric James Leffler. I'm going to apologize if I kind of butcher my last name. But I thought it was really cool. We did our walk in Chinatown. And it was a lot of different people. And I spend most of my, like a lot of the times when I go on the photo walks, I kind of, I'm a teacher, I can't help it, right? So it's like I spend most of my time just kind of foaming at the mouth and talking about different types of pictures and what to do and how to shoot and things like that. So there were groups that would just kind of come in, listen to what had to happen, and then just kind of take off. And I kept watching Eric out of the corner of my eye doing pictures, and it was just really, really cool how he was using reflections to be able to make nice shots. So I thought that was actually kind of cool. So that was one shot. I've got three shots here. The second shot is from Michael Frye, which was also a very, very humbling experience because if you don't know Michael is an absolutely phenomenal Yosemite photographer. He's a landscape photographer, but he's known most famously for shooting inside of Yosemite and having stuff inside of the Ansel Adams Museum and things like that. He's just a phenomenal, phenomenal photographer and a great guy. And I got a message from him, and he was just like, I'm coming to your walk. It was really, really nice to kind of see him you know, doing something different. A lot of the times I'm used to seeing him do, you know, big, big landscape work. And, you know, we had a lot of fun. It was really, really nice. I was standing right in front of this picture, and I tried looking at it really, really hard. And it was great to see that, you know, he pulled off something really nice with it. So that was a third one. Let's see. A third one that we had here was this one. So this one was from Joseph Fanvu. Joseph was a person who came in, you know, towards the end of the conference, towards the end of the registration time, and he was just like, hey, you want to come and hang out? So come on over. He does a lot of portrait work, and he was basically taking pictures of the people that were there at the conference. So a lot of fun was had. It's kind of hard to shoot at that time of day. You know, you're not really shooting. You don't have sunrise. You don't have sunset. So a lot of the times, you know, you're trying to struggle to get interior shots and take different things. And I was able to fire off a couple of shots. And as with anything, it turns into a giant HDR thing. But for the most part, you know, much fun was had, with the exception of dropping my 24 to 70 in the middle of all of that stuff. But that kind of sucked. But, you know, other than that, it was pretty good.
Well, thank you, RC. I know a lot of people had a little fun time on. I thought you were going to tell the story about the illegal Mahjong underground movement that you stumbled into.
That was pretty trippy. That was we're walking down these alleyways, and we have one of the guys that's kind of taking us through. And I mean, I don't know Chinatown. I kind of know Chinatown in that area. And he's like, well, go up this one spot, make a right, do this. And he's like, most of the times it's like, you know, you hear like Mahjong, and you hear all the people kind of playing, you hear the rustling of the dice. So we went down this one alleyway, and we found all you hear is just all of this rustling of dice. And we're sitting there, and we're just like, oh, this sounds really, really cool. But there isn't anybody in the street. It's just like an empty street. But you're just walking down this alleyway, and there's all these doors that are just gated. And it's just like metal fences. And you're just walking down. And sure enough, like I stop at one point, and I catch, like, out of the corner of my eye, I catch a whole bunch of people. This is like a weird light kind of hanging out. And I catch just the glimmer of a couple of people kind of just playing, you know. It looks like dominoes. I mean, I'm assuming it's Mahjong, but on a table. So I kind of just casually sit down. I was talking about, you know, being discreet and wanting to take a picture. So I set down my tripod, and I'm just kind of like looking around, not really looking at anything. And I'm just kind of setting my lens very, very quickly. So I see the guy, and the guy looks at me. I look at him, and I try to give him my best wave. The guy looks at me and goes like this.
Ooh.
And then just turns around and shuts the door. And I'm like, oh, dude, I didn't even get a chance to shoot. And when I look behind me, there's like 40 people behind me with cameras like this, aimed at the spot. And I'm like, guys, did we not forget the discreet part? And it was just interesting how everybody just kind of trained on that one spot. But the good part about it is, I mean, that same street had a Chinese flower designer just like tucked away inside a corner. You can barely see who it was. And they also had a fortune cookie factory, which I thought was really cool. I'd never seen a fortune cookie factory. And inside of there, there were two ladies making fortune cookies. And one of the ladies had a sign that said, if you take a picture, pay 50 cents. So we gave her $10, and they gave us like a whole bunch of warm fortune cookies. And I was able to rip off a pretty good HDR of that. So it turned out to be good.
Did you shoot on a tripod in the fortune cookie factory?
Yeah. I set down a tripod, and I think I shot like 2200 ISO, which, I mean, turned out to be pretty good for the most part. A lot of the times, you know, I tend to shoot 1600, 2200, and, you know, the images do stand. I'll show you real quick.
Some of those ones you showed me at the wine and cheese party of your hotel and all that, God, they're gorgeous. I don't think people get to see your work often enough.
Yeah, like this was the picture.
I love that. That's amazing.
It came out really, really good. And then this was another one of the flower lady that we did. So, but thanks, I appreciate that. Now, it's one of those things where it's like, I feel like I spent a lot of time talking about teaching. And sometimes it kind of shocks people. They're like, oh, my God, you shoot. And I'm like, yeah. So
somehow you've learned how to do that. You teach it, right?
In the middle of it, I've kind of figured that out. So, but yeah, all in all, it was a good time. It was a really, really good time. A very tiring time, but a very, very good time all the same.
Cool. Catherine, do you want to show us some stuff from your walk, and then maybe Karen can show us some stuff from our. Karen joined me on my photo walk, and because my bandwidth has been so bad, it's hard for me to prepare a lot of stuff.
So I over-prepared. I overcompensated by a lot.
We'll just go through them quickly. That way we can show off a lot of different people. That'll be good. But maybe, Catherine, if you're ready, you could go first if you like. I think you're muted. Over. Broadcast professional Catherine Hall coming to us live from Twit Studios. And she's still...
And...
There she is. Hello.
Karen, you can go ahead. Take it away. I'll go what? After you. I can go after you guys. It's fine. Go ahead.
Okay, Karen. You're on stage now. This is it.
Oh, I'm nervous now. God.
I didn't give you any time to be nervous. I just threw it on you.
Oh, yeah, you did. I don't need any time to get nervous. I always have that at the ready. I'm kind of like always nervous. It just doesn't take much. All right. Am I sharing yet? Okay.
Yes.
So...
You're oversharing.
Oh, shut up. Okay. Can you see this?
Yes.
This is our fantastic group as we started our photo walk. Peter Adams took this photo of the group, and the group took this picture of Peter Adams taking a picture of the group, which is always fun. Joe Ercoli took this picture, and then we had our neat cloud formation. Am I going too fast, too slow?
No, this is good. I like this pace.
Okay, good. The Port of San Francisco shouldn't be missed, and we didn't. Really cool sculpture that is perplexing to photograph, but Keith Cuddeback did a nice job. I like it. And then, who's that? See, I thought this was inappropriate. There were so many pictures of Trey, but I thought this was appropriate because it was shot through a spaceship. Somehow it all makes sense to me. So there's Trey in a spaceship. And he is a local to Earth, even though he's moved to another place on the Earth, so this kind of tied in. I'm a storyteller. It all has to work for me. Then we had this fantastic moment. Trey pointed out some cool cars in this parking lot, and simultaneously a neat cloud formation, and Almus Null got them both. I thought he was very clever. And then we have Darlene Hildebrandt, who got this reflection, which I also love. Toby Harriman did this. I love this. It's like in some old-fashioned or some weird movie, or I don't know. I just loved it. Crossing, that's the ferry building. People, I don't know if they're coming or going, and does it really matter? I don't think so.
I think he shot that with an ND filter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I saw him set up as we were crossing the street.
I was on this photo walk, but I saw these pictures of the ferry building, and I wasn't there, and I have no idea why. It's like a blackout. I have no idea where I was during that time. But I wasn't with you. I have no idea. No memory.
Yeah, that's when you did Ludes, isn't it? San Francisco.
I remember something about a spaceship and maybe Ludes. I don't know. Yeah. Apparently you ran into security. Maybe that's why. I had a notion you'd run into the law, and I didn't want to have a record. So you got in a little trouble there, but you got through it.
We got everyone thrown out of the ferry building at the same time.
That's awesome. I must have known with my psychic powers that you were going to be in trouble, and I hate being in trouble. So, but that was a shot that somebody got before they got tossed. Keith Cuddeback got that shot. I thought this was interesting. I did this sculpture, this is Omar AlQabandi. I apologize for butchering your name. It's a wonderful name. And this is a fabulous photograph of this sculpture that everybody took in a different way. So I just thought these were fascinating. And, of course, Trey versus the sculpture. And again, the cool sky and the sculpture. And I just thought it was really neat what everybody did with it. Including this, Alan Morris shot all people shooting things. And so this is a good action shot.
Hey, cool. Karen, if you pop some of these up, be sure to say who the photographer was.
Yeah, I did. I have been.
Oh, okay. Some of those you went through quickly. I didn't know if they were all the same person.
No, I mentioned their name.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Would you like an instant replay?
Wonderful. Keep going. You're doing great.
Thank you. So, again, Alan Morris, who took wonderful people shots. Including this one. I thought it was very action-y. Loved it. And Darlene Hildebrandt did this one. And I loved it. It's just this little girl just wants to, like, crawl into his lap and see his camera, and I loved it. And he's completely oblivious to, but she's just like, what is that? So she'll be on a photo walk in about 5 years. She'll be leading one. I thought this was nice. This is Alan Morris again, and just the nature of photo walks and sharing. You know, people helping each other out, like, what's this setting, or how do I do this? And everybody's helping everybody, and I just think that's one of the really neat things about photo walks in general. Kimberly Hayworth did this one. Cool close-up of, I guess, I don't know. You can't even tell. It's just cool. I like all the bokeh in the background and so on. And then, Trey, you set up in front of the Embarcadero Center, and everybody did a different thing with it. And here Dave Bell caught the sunburst and the name and the big towering inferno in the back there, which I liked. And a totally different take of the same spot. So that's what I found so fascinating. Let's go back for a second. Alex Shamis did this one. And then Jamie Zartman did this of, I mean, it's the only one of this, and I don't even know what it was. It was a sculpture, but there's a reflection of the Bay Bridge in the background, and it looks like a little face, and I just thought it was so interesting on so many levels.
I don't remember that either.
Yeah, I know. It was the only one that I found of this particular thing. So somehow he had a unique take on it. Omar AlQabandi did this one of, the reason I did this is I love it, but then people did this. So Beverly Anderson Sanchez had that take of the same sculpture through a different place, as did Keith Cuddeback. So it's basically all the same shot, but totally different setups. And I just think that's so interesting. That's what I love about photo walks, is seeing what everybody's take of things is. And then Tom Hero? I'm not sure how to say his last name. This is also Embarcadero Center, and I love it, with all the reflection and patterns and whatnot. Sly Vegas. So then we went to the Hyatt Regency, booked a room, we all stayed over. Do you remember that part, Trey?
Yeah, well, I wasn't invited to that part, Karen.
Oh, really? Yeah. Well, yeah, we had a good time. So pre-party. So then we had, this is Omar again, of the overall view of the lobby, which is insane. And so everybody, Keith Cuddeback, had this take.
Yeah, Sly, it's a had crazy this lobby. I would have never gone in there if someone hadn't suggested it. I think it was Sly Vegas suggested we go in. So I was like, oh, that doesn't sound very exciting. The Hyatt lobby, who cares? But it was awesome inside.
Yeah, all these shots are from the inside. This is Dave Bell again. Sly, of course, I like to refer to him as Steven, since that's his real name. I'd like to say, hello, Steven. Joseph Ip took this, again, of the lobby. Looks totally different. And I love this, before we leave the lobby, Joette Wangsgard did this reflection in the piano of everything, and I just thought it was
smart.
Yep, really smart.
That sculpture in there is really rad.
Up at the top there?
That big circular thing.
Yeah, I know. Isn't that neat? So I'm kind of shopping around for places to go back to, and I think I know where I'm going. So then we ended up down at Rincon Park with this big old bow and arrow in the ground, which I have no clue what it signifies, but it's interesting. Keith Cuddeback again did a nice shot there. So I thought what I would do is, you know, that's the overall, and then Charlie Blake, who is Sly Vegas' significant other, does some wonderful posing. You know, she's a wonderful model, so we got to do model shooting. So that was everybody shooting, and then shooting towards the Bay Bridge, which I thought was neat. And then this is some of what they were shooting. Darlene Hildebrandt did this one. Joette Wangsgard. Darlene again, which is just a whole other take. And Joette Wangsgard did this, which is Sly and Charlie together, and I love that with all their cool tattoos. Okay, then there was this whole episode, and this little dog running back and forth, and all these photographers shooting this little dog is like, just running across the grass. So that's what this little dog looked like. And then, and that was Pradeep Das. Darlene Hildebrandt did this is the same dog, different, like, blurry thing, and I love it. And then this is what the scene looked like, which at first I thought, well, that's not a good shot with the big old crane. And it's a perfect shot because look at the dog in the lower right-hand corner. And this is as big as I could make it. I'm sorry. I don't know if you can see that. This little dog is flat out flying above the ground. So that was hilarious. And then this is the crowd, including the little white dog, all watching this little dog run back and forth. And then we're back to the group.
Cool.
So.
Thank you, Karen. That was great.
Sure.
That was great. And thanks again, everyone, for coming out for that DOE. In the beginning of it, I recorded a new video of, like, what's in my bag, the lenses and my cameras and that sort of thing. And I've just finished editing together that video. And as soon as I get decent bandwidth, I will upload it and share it with everybody, because I know not everyone could see what was happening. And people are always interested in what's in photographers' bags. So that'll be a fun video. Coming soon. Okay. Also coming soon is Catherine. Are you ready, Catherine?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
So our walk was at Fisherman's Wharf, and here's our group photo. And thank you, Lisa Duncan, for taking it. And we lost about half our group by the time we got to the photo. So if you're not included, it's not because I don't love you. It's just we were late doing it.
We're not quite seeing it yet. We still see you.
Oh, sorry. Hold on. Well, we don't
Maybe
really need to look
show
at the
us
photos.
The, interpretive
we
dance.
Can just look at me. Great. All right.
Do charades. We'll have to imagine what it looked like.
It's split. It's because my screen's split right now, and I could see it on. Hold on a second. Desktop. Which desktop do I want to show? I have so many things. Hold on. Sorry, guys. I think
we still see you. Over.
Oh, wait. Hold on. I'm sorry.
You can do it.
I can do it.
You can do
it.
There. We see it. We see it.
Okay. Sorry. I just like to keep things interesting. All right. Now we can see the group photo, right? Like miniature size?
There you go.
Yeah, there you go. Now we're talking.
So there's our awesome group, which I have to say, one of my favorite things about photo walks is how you all start off as pseudo strangers, and then by the end, you definitely get a big bond. So it was a lot of fun. But first, I wanted to say thank you to Elizabeth Hahn. You may know her as the photo walk queen, and she definitely earned her title on this trip. She was really the one that pulled the photo walk together, with also Doug Kay did a lot of planning. So I want to just say thanks to them. And also thanks to Michael, who's in the middle, for also coaching with us. So we had Doug and Michael out with me, which has made it a lot more fun and a lot more to learn, because they were helping teach along the way. And then we were happy enough to be graced with Vincent Moe's presence too, which was great. So we found a boat that had my name on it. That was kind of cool. They dared me to get on it, and I did. We have a couple awards for our photo walk, and this won first place out of all of the shots, and
cool.
I want to announce the winner on the show today. So this is
Whoa.
The first time. Yeah.
Who is
go.
It?
Lisa Duncan, and it was the first shot of a Studebaker that we just stumbled across on the way, just walking along. And the reason it was selected is for several things. Just use of color, great use of depth of field, perspective, just very dynamic image. And Lisa had a ton of great ones. So I just wanted to acknowledge her and say thank you so much for inspiring us. And she won actually a full suite collection from Nick Software. So that includes the color effects, the silver effects, Vivesa, all of them, so which is huge. I use those all the time. They're great. So thanks, Lisa, for coming and sharing. Moving all along, this is Sean Colley's image, and I really love this image. I love the texture and the lighting and the color and the depth of field. I think this is a beautiful shot. We went out near all these ships, which was a lot of fun. This was another shot. This was done by Richard Hay, and I really liked this image because it showed sort of the contrast between old San Francisco and new San Francisco, and just showing that, you know, these ships and the way the city's been built up in more recent times. So we also, this is where we started, which was the cable car building. This shot's by Robin Wilson, and I really love her treatment of the shot. It makes it feel, even though it's got a ton of dynamic range, the toning and whatnot makes it feel kind of antique-ish, if you will. And it's a very beautiful image. I like the composition, the colors, the treatment. And being at Fisherman's Wharf, it was great because we got to see Alcatraz. And this shot is by Sean Colley. And this was part of, we had a scavenger hunt. So this is one of his images from the scavenger hunt. And, here's part of the scavenger hunt too was Coit Tower, and this is by Angie Smith. This shot was by Robin Wilson as well, and this was, I really like this image. I love the depth of field, the colors. I like the shine of the sun reflection. Just a lot of storytelling, warm, inviting, great perspective. Another shot by Lisa Duncan, going back to color palettes. We're looking at the warm and this going on the opposite end of the spectrum, having those really nice cool blues, but also very rich saturated palette with rich textures as well. This image is by Angie Smith. Thought it was fun. It was interesting. I love the treatment of it. This one also by Angie Smith. And here is a picture of us doing our demo. And I like to carry the Sun Bounce around wherever I go for people that know me. It's not the smallest thing in the world, but it creates really, really beautiful light. So we were doing the demo with that. And Trey, this is Jess Newcomb encroaching on your territory.
What's going on here?
That's where your walk was.
Ah.
He started off, I don't know, this is from the walk. He said this is where he parked his car, which is really far away.
Yeah.
So this is actually back over where you are. But by the way, Ferry Building area is by far one of my favorite places to shoot, FYI. So I was a little jealous when you got that area.
Oh. So well, maybe we'll switch next time.
Yeah, I sent my people your way, okay?
Thank you.
This is a shot by Sean Colley, and I just love the depth of field and the storytelling created from that depth. So these are just a few. This is by Richard Hay, and this is once again at the cable car tracks, and I just liked his use of perspective, and he was definitely laying on the ground for this one. So props for getting down low and getting creative. This was also by Richard Hay. Just a nice story between the ships and the island, Alcatraz, and the Studebaker. And then this will end with this one. This is Dennis Lodes. Once again, great storytelling with the depth of field and creating that sort of dynamic interest between having a really sharp foreground and a softened background and story. So it was, oh, I like this one too. Dennis Lodes. We'll end with this one. Really, once again, using great sense of depth of field juxtaposed with a very nice composition. So it was overall a really incredible walk. And I know we're still coming, images are still coming in. So there's tons. Oh, I really love this one too by Jess Newcomb. So they're still coming in, but really great group. And thanks everyone for coming on the walk. Kimberly Tweed.
Fun. Yeah. It was kind of neat, wasn't it? Doing it before the conference. That way you were able to make like all these new friends before the conference, and you could see them walking around, and it was sort of unexpected. So I'm sure the same thing happened to you, Catherine.
It was great, too, and also just having such a small group, you know, having it 50 or less, it really allowed you to connect with everyone. So by the time the conference came, you actually had real bonds, not just kind of like a superficial, I think you were on my photo walk, but I can't really remember feeling. So it was really, really nice, and it was a great group.
Did you have any food on your photo walk? Did you take people to dinner? I heard that some photo walks, not mine, but others actually had food involved.
Yeah, not yours. I knew that.
We were shooting till 6:30. That's why the photo walk was like, by the time we did the formal photo, about half of them had already had to leave. But there was just so much to shoot, and so we just kept shooting, and by the time we finished, it was time to get back. So no, we did not. I did not give them food. I made them suffer.
Yeah, I think RC's group got food. It was not a good situation. We worked so hard. We were going to the last minute, just like you guys, and it was nonstop.
Our group ended up at a Thai restaurant.
What?
Yeah, that's how we ended.
Well, that's smart. If you want it to make sure that you have beverage, just go with Lotus.
Yeah, what were you, Lotus, were you just haranguing Colby until he took you guys someplace for some Thai food?
Well, yeah, actually, speaking of that, how is Colby even functioning?
I know. He was like, all just coming back from Iceland, had no sleep whatsoever. So he you couldn't tell, though. He was in great spirits and did a great job and came to dinner with us afterwards. So you wouldn't have known that he hadn't slept in like 3 days.
So Lotus is going to be sharing us a few photos from Colby's walk here pretty soon. But let's break it up from the girl fest, the estro fest, and go over to Alex.
Oh, nice.
Who has many sensitive artistic feminine qualities, but is still more man than woman, easily.
Nice. So,
Alex, I don't know how to give you a better intro than that.
Well, I'm fine with it. Whatever. It's all fine. Yeah, let me tell you about my photo walk. It was my actually first photo walk ever. And it started from confusion. It was pretty cool after it ended happily, you know. We got this link and the name of the place where we're going to meet. And the name and the link were pointing to different places. You know, Treasure Island for me is a completely new place. It's abandoned old military base, right? Kind of empty stuff. And I clicked the link, and I've seen on Google Map, on, you know, I know where to meet with people. And 30% of the group meet me there. The rest, 70%, meet where it was the name. It was actually rugby club, some old rugby club. So it was two different places. And yeah, Noah Katz, I know him. He was doing a lot of stuff for studio photography inside. But called me in like 10 minutes probably, because we were sitting and waiting for group. Where is everybody? We know it should be 39 people, and we have like 10. And he said, Alex, where are you? I said, waiting at the point, and whatever it was. He said, no, it's a rugby club. I said, I have no idea where a rugby club is, and I just followed the map. So anyway, when we got there, it was actually like 5 minutes to walk to the rest of the group. It was pretty cool, except it was really windy. You probably know if you've been in San Francisco at that place, it's a lot of wind. So let me show you. We did first group photo. It was kind of cool. Let me show you. Yeah, this is our group. And then people start walking all around. You see that cloud formation you just talked about, it just starts forming on this shot. Then people start shooting that side of the, you know, the island, and I start shooting too. And this is my probably 10 minutes later shot. You see this cool, kind of almost like an eye, right? The cloud. Like usually I use fisheye, HDR, whatever, all this stuff. And then I start shooting actually people and participants. This is Jeff. Oh, I forgot his name. Sorry, I'm very, really bad with people names. It's probably something in my head. Not right, but doctor said it's not going to be fixed soon, so I'm sorry, guys. This is just, you see, I was shooting against the sun, and it's fisheye. I used flash, and usually to get, actually, this is only raw conversion. There is no other post-processing on this, and let's say, and this, no other post-processing except raw conversion picture. I'm using flash to highlight subject, right, even if it's against the sun. Dial -1 exposure correction for the ambient and +1 for the flash. And this how it works, right? We have a sun, it's right here, and it's still properly exposed. And sun, I mean, it's almost like an HDR in one shot because we underexpose ambient and overexpose subject, a little bit overexposed, which is kind of pretty cool because where flash is not, if it's too far, it's dark, you see? So, a little bit technical, you know, I'm technical, right? Sorry, guys. I will be talking about this a little bit. Mark Squiera, we've been kind of friends through Google Plus with him since August, and eventually I met him. Great guy. So, we had this kind of shooting, little shooting here, and actually, Zhenia, she's my wife, she was shooting, I mean, video. We got this video from this hangar, from Photowalk. And then we went to other side of the island. And this is a few shots I've got there. This, and yeah, I had only one macro, actually. It's 118 millimeters macro lens. I got it for Photoshop. The rest was all wide angle, so it's kind of cool. This one, well, yeah, I know the Christy Nielsen got this one, but it was a bit later. Unfortunately, we didn't go to that lady with me when Photowalk is finished. I was hoping to be there, but, well, we went other way. So Christy Nielsen took this photo. And after we're done on that part of the island, we went inside. You know, there are a lot of empty space, like strange buildings. This is no cut image. You know, there is...
Oops. We're losing you a little bit. Your audio cut out there, Alex. We heard that that was a shot by Noah Katz, who, by the way, is a very nice guy. I got to meet him and talk to him for a while I was there.
I have a question while he's coming back. What did you all do, like you who led Photowalks? What was like the teaching segment or the extra segment that you did, like Trey, you did your bag. So what did the rest of you do? Catherine, what did you do? Did you like kind of do a little teaching session?
Well, I usually when I do walks, I'll sort of stop and teach along the way whenever I feel inspired. But one of the things I like to talk about is lighting, and so that's why I bring around the sun bounce. But it's not really formal. It's more just if I see something that I feel like I could impart knowledge, or if I see someone struggling with something, then I'll just stop and say, hey, and whoever's around me listens, and if they're not around me and ignore me, it's fine, too, as well.
I was going to ask RC that, but I just realized he's gone.
Yeah, he dropped out, too.
So I had about, like, one person out of 50 listening to me.
Yeah, does that include yourself?
No. Nice.
Actually, my assistant. Never saw.
The one who's paid to listen to you.
Hey, Catherine.
Yeah.
One second, I'll switch microphones here. I was saying I like your cup, the Canon.
Oh yeah.
Is it the 16-35L? The cup.
It is. And you know what's funny is I keep screwing at the bottom, and it's full of water, liquid, so it's good. It can't come off.
Yeah. No, it's the first time I saw one of those. A friend of mine, he said, "Oh, look what I got," and he threw it at me quite aggressively, and I panicked.
Oh no. It's not actually mine, it's Twit's, but yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, it's good fun.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Hey, so since we seem to have lost Alex, Lotus, do you have some stuff you'd like to share from your photo walk?
Yeah. I was given the privilege of helping Colby Brown on his walk, and we started at Union Square. Let me get the screen share going here.
Okay. We also are very willing to hear any stories that might not be fit for prime time. We're on the internet, so anything goes, Lotus.
So you're going to pull that one out for me to know, huh?
Well, I figured if anyone would take that ball and run with it, you would. I'm just letting you know the opportunity exists.
Okay. Well, we didn't, and Colby didn't have any specific teaching lessons or anything, but we did have a recurring theme of, it was kind of a teaching thing where we were talking about the fun of photobombing, so it was a recurring theme throughout the entire walk. Where, so I don't know how many great photos people actually got because some of us were having way too much fun with the art of the photobomb, but it was fun. Here, this first shot is by Amy Hayden, and this is when we started in Union Square. You can see Colby giving us all direction, the giant on the mountain. That's the back of my head there. Here's a shot by Brian Rose. He was on the walk with us. So we had the illustrious mustache along for the walk. Very nice. This gentleman, who I didn't know before, Sandeep Patil, he's got a couple of nice shots of buildings. I think this was, when we left Union Square, we went to Yerba Gardens, and then we went down 4th Street. I think this is down 4th Street somewhere. We've got this one. which I really like. A long time ago when I first got into photography, I never saw this kind of stuff. I didn't look at buildings as being beautiful. And the more time I spend around other photographers, I'm learning kind of a new eye. My eye is getting greater, I think, because I start to see what people see when they look at buildings like this, the beautiful angles and lines, which I never noticed before. So that's another cool thing I think about going on photo walks, is that when you get to see the photos later, you learn a little bit, you know, about things that you didn't see and that you can capture the next time you're out. Joel Horwath got this little cable car or trolley. I get confused between the two. Which one's a trolley and which one's a cable car?
That's a cable car, and the trolleys look like old buses on rails. And the cable car's on Powell Street, and the other ones are on Market Street.
Which one goes ding ding?
Cable car.
Which one goes choo choo?
Train.
Thank you, Dave. You watch Thomas the Train. Thomas the Tank Engine.
Joel actually also wrote, on this same post where he's got this photo, he wrote this really nice kind of a couple of paragraphs about his experience at the conference, and I couldn't say it any better. Like, you guys should go look at his profile, Joel Horwath, and read it, and it's just, he enjoyed himself so much getting to go to the conference and spending so much time with other photographers, you know, this group of people who share his passion, and then, you know, going on the photo walks and seeing the city, and he just had a really great experience, and he did a really nice write-up about it. I thought that was really cool to see someone else say very eloquently kind of exactly how I had felt as well. So this was one of the photos that he took during that photo walk with Colby Brown. And then here's, I'm going to show a couple of photos from Chris Chabot, who was also on that walk, some kind of just, you know, portraits. I think this was still when we were in Union Square. I liked this one a lot. And then the next one from Chris is, I think, my favorite photo that I've seen anybody post from the walk so far.
Nice.
Which is this gentleman, which I actually got a photo of him too, but now I don't want to show it because Chris's is so much better than mine. But I love this. Guy was just kind of snoozing. He had pulled two chairs together right in the middle of Union Square, and he was just taking a nap. I think if I can actually pull up mine. That's a photo of me. This is the guy, when I shot him, he was waking up and giving me this look like, you know, what are you doing? But I like Chris's much better. It's really nice. And then the last few photos I have are actually representations that I didn't have a very good time on the walk. I was not having fun at all.
No.
And this one is by Amy Hayden. And here's one by Christiana Pierce. So we went to Yerba Gardens. And there was a little playground there, so we took advantage of the slide. That's Amy Hayden shooting me coming down the slide face first. And then the carousel by Juan Gonzalez. So as you can tell, I didn't have a good time at all on Colby's walk. But yeah, those were some of the best photos that I've seen posted so far. And like I said, my favorite one was Chris's of this older gentleman. We ended up back at the Thai restaurant. We walked quite a ways, and we all picked out a place to eat dinner together because it was getting towards the end of the photo walk, and we all had that feeling that we didn't want it to end. You know, that is it time for us to say goodbye tonight thing, and so we decided to have dinner together.
Well, I like that shot of Juan Gonzalez on the Ferris wheel. I didn't think he could fit in his skirt that short.
That was by Juan Gonzalez.
So I was confused. I see.
Yeah, we wore matching outfits that day.
Yeah. Yeah, you guys are cute. Okay. Well, Alex, we dropped you right when you were showing us a photo by Noah Katz when you were inside the courtyard, and then your bandwidth got used up for the month or something.
Yeah, looks like it dropped whole connection. It's crazy. Sorry about this, guys. So I can continue?
Yeah, no, please continue.
Thank you.
I always feel like I'm talking to a Russian spy.
Oh, Russian spy, yeah, so it's still, yeah.
He's like, yeah, I've never gotten that one before.
Trey, you probably didn't, I mean, you've been many times in Russia, right? Did you have any kind of problems, issues with Russian spies? I mean, not the FBI, whatever they have.
The KGB?
Well, yeah, it used to be KGB, now it's FSB, right?
Right, the FSB, no, only in Ukraine I had some issue, but not... Oh, really? Yeah.
Yeah, good, yeah, I'm from Ukraine, we are much better on this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I was talking about this building that it kind of reminded me Soviet Union and Chernobyl, actually. You know, that you've been in Chernobyl, right, in Pripyat, you've seen those abandoned... buildings empty, you know. They're not this one still has windows, you know, not broken glasses, but still kind of similar feeling. Yeah, and after that, we got inside and actually start shooting like a studio shot. I was showing that we can overpower sun with two speed lights. I got one speedlight here and one speedlight. The other guy was holding it on the right from no cuts. And yeah, he was our model. So we kind of shoot, and I showed, like, you see, sun was behind him, and this is sun, you know, and the rest is just strobe, you know, kind of cool shot. So, as usual, you know, I'm a studio guy, and if I could, I always try to, you know, kind of create studio whenever it's possible. Yeah. This is our last group shot in some, again, empty warehouse or whatever. You see, it's old dryer, washing machines, you know, that refrigerators, whatever. So that was it. It was pretty cool experience for me, pretty interesting. And, I meet many guys, and, I mean, many people who I kind of knew already, and you meet new friends. Which is great. I kind of like it.
Cool. Thanks, Alex. So now that we've kind of shared all those photos and stuff, before we get into Google Plus discoveries, maybe some people that you found you might want to share with us. Catherine, do you have some screenshots, or can you tell us a little bit more about your top model release app? You might be muted again.
No, I'm good.
Oh, wait.
Okay. Wait, I have two. I'm glad you came to me, Trey, because I had two other quick things. We had two other awards that I forgot to mention.
Whoa.
We had a scavenger hunt award, and that goes to Richard Hay, and that's for his Hercules and Alcatraz shot. So, yay, Richard. And he gets to have Data Color Spider 4 Pro. And if you guys know, do you guys use Spider to calibrate your monitor, anyone?
I used it once, but then...
Do you guys calibrate your monitor?
I do at work, but not here.
Oh, my goodness.
No, I ride dirty.
your colors can go crazy and no one will notice, Trey.
I print my own photos, so...
Yeah, no, I definitely... I've always calibrated my monitor. But anyway, the Spider Pro is amazing, and that's what I use. So we're giving out that to Richard for winning the scavenger hunt. And then we also... This wasn't planned to give away, but Robin Wilson had so many beautiful photos that we came up with a runner-up prize, and she's going to get a copy of Top Model Release. And so I just wanted to acknowledge her for a runner-up for first place for the competition. So
awesome.
That's that.
Okay, wait a minute. You gave her a prize that cost $2.99?
$4.99.
Did I get that right? Oh, $4.
Yeah, she could buy it. It's almost as much as buying a Starbucks coffee. No, it's more than anything. It's just about acknowledging. And I wasn't even screen sharing that, was I? Here's Robin's, just real quick so you guys can see. Okay. More than anything, it was just for acknowledging. Screen share. I'm getting thrown because my stuff's on a million monitors here at Twit. I just wanted to acknowledge him. This is Robin's. And actually, the real reward, Trey, is that she's on your show.
Priceless.
There you go. Yeah. Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah. Wow. Her life will never be the same. You know?
And so, yeah, let's talk top model release for a second.
Yeah, tell us why people need to part with their hard-earned $4.39 and give 30% of it to Apple.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, no, did it do the thing? All right, crap. This is the last time I try to do too much. Do you guys have, like, a blank screen? Hold on.
Yes, we see. It's all black.
They set me up with all these monitors, and it's more.
And.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Maybe Twit ran out of bandwidth. That's not good.
I'm feeling quite good about the New Zealand bandwidth now, Trey.
Yeah. So anyway, while Eden is here, you know, Eden didn't join us on the Photowalks out of San Francisco. He's got a nonstop photo walk here in New Zealand. I wanted to give him an opportunity to share a few of his photos. So I'm going to mute up and let him take a few seconds here and go through some of his stuff.
All right, back to my microphone. I just put one in the link there. That was from Trey's last visit back in October of 2010. Yeah, 2010. Long time ago. So what I kind of do is I'm an IT consultant by trade, but I sort of take time out to do photography to keep me sane. So let me just share my screen here. 1 second. Desktop one. There we go. Alrighty. Everyone seeing that okay? Big time aviation enthusiast. And one of the things that I love doing is chilling out at the local airport runway and shooting various planes that come in with a camera, not anything else, because I don't think the airport would like that. So I chill out down there quite regularly and take a few photos, and I was at an air show recently where this Hercules was. When I'm not hanging out locally, I kind of go further afield and I check out locations like this on the way to Cromwell, where I'm situated in Queenstown. You can sort of drive 30 minutes in any direction and you end up with interesting locations with various subjects to shoot, and you can get quite close to a lot of action. So this is this mysterious bunker that kind of shoots into the side of the mountain. And I've sort of referenced it to Aperture Science and Portal, where you've got the secret bunker going into in the middle of a cornfield. I thought this would make kind of a cool story. So often when I put photos on the blog, I do a bit of a write-up and a story and explain sort of my thought process and what was going through my mind. I do a fair bit of astrophotography, and I don't the screen share is probably not going to bring this out, but this is a landscape photo taken at about 2 in the morning, I think. Yeah, 2 a.m. And it was a full moon, and I exposed the stars for about 45 minutes thereabouts, and got a lot of illumination from the full moon on the landscape. So if I zoom in here, you can see the you might be able to see the stars moving around the celestial south pole and the landscape in the background. So I thought that was quite nice. On the subject of photo walks, this is one from the photo walk recently in Queenstown, just last Christmas. And I just put that up on my blog last night with a bit of a write-up about why I've been off the internet for so long, because I've been so busy. And I quite like the colour and the composition and how it all came out and how the sun was hitting these branches and the rocks in the foreground. I thought that was quite nice. Probably one of my better photos this year was this one from St. Bathans in central Otago, where I sort of a photo mission with a friend, and we sort of ventured through the sort of Otago landscape. And we actually, this photo was taken quite late at night, 7:30, so that was after the sun had already gone down. So I had to use 19 photos and quite a high ISO to get that landscape exposed correctly. When I'm not taking landscape photos, I like to mix it up a bit and do play with fire and reflections and all sorts of fun things like that. So photos like that are always nice to go out and experiment with. This was a bit of steel wool on fire being spun around in a circle with a 9-second exposure, which came out really nice. And that one I thought looked a little like a portal as well with the reflection in the water. And I like taking photos of animals and pets. This is our dog Deagle at Gibston, which I think is, you know, clearly he's miserable, not enjoying life at all. It's been sitting over the fence over and over again. And yeah, just a few photos of pets and animals, and that's kind of my my photo story there. So I can see I'm into a lot of different things.
Thank you. Thank you, Eden. That was cool. I'm glad people got to see your work there. Well, so Catherine didn't come back. That's too bad. Maybe let's just jump into some of our favorite Google Plus discoveries. We always like to close out the show with this because there's often people that you ought to follow that you may not know about. Or maybe, if you're like me, I have many circles. I have like a photographer's circle with a bunch of people in it. And then I have another circle, which is sort of an elite circle. It's called Great Photographers. And this is where I go when I just know I need guaranteed inspiration. So maybe some of these people could just jump right into your more elite circle if you do what I do. And I see Lotus has one. I'm looking at chat here to see who has their ones ready. It looks like Lotus is ready to go and fully loaded. So let's have it, Lotus.
All right. My share is a lovely lady named Amanda Recker. And this is her actual self-portrait by her. So she has some really nice self-portraits. She also has some really beautiful portraits, some portrait work, and I enjoy looking at her portraits here. So I'm just going to kind of go through a few of them. I really like her style. I like the light, kind of bright, beautiful skin. Of course, the subject matter doesn't hurt either, right? But so I don't do portrait work like with other people. So this, I think, you know, the things outside of my own personal scope also impress me. So when I see beautiful portraits by other people, I think I'm very drawn to those. Little boudoir. And I haven't gotten to know Amanda incredibly well, but I've talked to her a little bit, and she has a fun personality, and she seems like
I love
like
her
a,
lighting. I love the variety of what she does in her lighting.
Yeah, isn't it lovely?
Yeah, it really is. It's all different, too.
All of it feels very alive to me. I don't know how to describe it other than that, and I think it is exactly that. It's the light in the photos that she's achieving. So Amanda Recker is my share, and she's a great portrait photographer, and she posts a lot of self-portraits, too. So that's my recommendation.
Cool. Good one, Lotus. And it looks like Alex has one ready here for us.
Yes. Yeah, I met in San Francisco another guy. Actually, he's from Russia. But it's not like why I picked up him. He's a studio photographer, and like me, he's very kind of, he likes technically challenging stuff, and what he does, it's amazing. I'm going to show you his work on his portfolio just in seconds. It's like I found the niche on Google Plus long time ago, and this is probably another guy who's kind of hopefully will join us on Hangouts. We do. Okay, so you see simple things, for example, simple stuff, right? Subjects like glass, but how to shoot it, I don't know. If you never try studio photography, it may look easy, but this is not. And this guy is great, you know, at this thing. We had a little kind of photo walk with him at night in San Francisco. We talked, and wow, he has great ideas, and the way he shoots stuff, it's just, you know, just amazing.
A minute ago, that glass upside down that you were showing, was that smoke underneath it?
I'm jumping here. Which one?
I think it was in the simple things.
Yeah, this is smoke, for example, yeah. It's simple, but how he got it, right?
Go back to that other shot. I think it was a martini glass or something upside down. Is that
this one?
Smoke inside of the glass there?
That's cool.
Or is that something?
It may be smoke, or it may be, you know, I don't know, like wrap plastic, you know?
Okay, I was just curious. It caught my eye. It's really interesting photo.
Yeah, and you see how he cut the glass? I'm not sure how it was. Was it really cut like this, or it was glass maybe like this? I don't know. Again, simple things, but to shoot them, it's not sometimes simple. And he knows how to play with light, make it work for him. Yeah, I really hope he'll be a contributor actually here. Let me tell a little bit about this project. I kind of didn't tell it when I was... it's I call it 40G. This new stuff, which I, you know, like website where I put all my tutorials, all my work there, and I hope other studio photographers will join me to share, you know, their knowledge. So that's probably my project, which I was working last few months, and not only studio photography, right? We got here all that stuff going on.
Cool. Thanks, Alex. I'll share one here. I think Eden has one, and then we'll finish up to see if Catherine, do you have a one to share with us? Google Plus Discovery as well. And Karen.
Yes.
Karen, have you? Okay. So we'll see if Catherine can get us together. I know she's having some connectivity trouble. Maybe Leo didn't pay his bandwidth bill. But so in the meantime, I got to show you this girl that I met at the Google Plus Photographers Conference. Okay, this is going to blow your mind. I don't know how to best show you this. Let me just share my screen. Okay. So this girl's name is Terry Lou Dansler. And you see these kind of photos that she does. Here's an example. So here's the thing, is that she only shoots with her iPhone. And she only edits the photos with her iPad.
Oh, my God.
I know. She's crazy. So we did blind critiques up on stage, and her photos came up. And I already knew who she was, so the deck was kind of loaded. I already liked her, so she got a great critique from me, of course. But, yeah, if you go look at her photos, there's something for everybody in here. Really, really amazing stuff. I don't know, you know... It's interesting that she chooses to constrain herself like this. But it's just photo after photo, really, really amazing stuff. And I'm going to get her on an upcoming show, and she's also agreed to write a book for Flatbooks to talk about how she does all of this and what tools she uses and, you know, I mean, how fun. I think a lot of us have cell phones and iPads.
What's that one with the feet and stockings?
This one? Oh, it's sort of a triptych type there.
Oh.
Yeah.
That is so cool.
It really is amazing what can be done with phones now.
Wow.
You can tell that a person who's very creative can really put good use to what's available.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, really, really cool. Anyway, so you guys circle her up and watch for her to write a flat book, and also watch for her to be on an upcoming show with us. I think she's fantastic. Let me unscreen share.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
Cool. So before we go to Karen and Catherine, let's start with Eden. Let's do our multi-button switcheroo here.
Okay, everyone hear me?
Yes.
Okay. One person that I've been following quite a lot lately and I really wanted to take the time to feature is a friend of mine who I've been primarily following on Facebook called Denny Zero, and I'm just making sure that he's watching. I'm just going to share my screen here, bear with me. So this guy, I sort of met him online in much the same way that I met Trey and everyone else. I sort of just started talking to him, and since then I've been communicating quite a bit, so you should be able to see my screen now. Danny's work is absolutely breathtaking, and I've been really inspired to see a lot of what he's been putting up lately. I've just kind of gone through his 500px photo stream to pull out a few of the ones that I think are brilliant. He just has this brilliant editing style. He does a lot of stuff with portraiture, shallow depth of field. This is one I thought I'd just start out with, showing how he's, you know, highlighting the 800 as his new camera.
Hey, Eden, I see myself in the Hangout instead of your photos.
Hang on one second.
Yeah, I just got really confused.
Let me just, I'll just share the right screen, bear with me. There we go. Okay, I'll share that window. It's window by window, not the whatever is on my screen. Can you see that now?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So this is a photo from Danny recently, which is highlighting his new D800 with a really nice depth of field and excellent color palette. So I thought I'd start out with that. The back in New Year, he put up this amazing HDR from, I think it's Malaysia, correct me if I'm wrong, but I thought, yeah, Trey would know. That's an amazing HDR with the fireworks. I thought that was just spectacular when I first saw it. One that I saw recently, which I loved as well, was this one from Australia. He lived in Australia for a while, and this incredible sunset. And I just love his processing style and the way that he brings out color and light. And much the same way with this one here. That sunset just absolutely blows my mind. You know, in many ways, I think the foreground is just as important as the background of the clouds. But that sky is just surreal, absolutely incredible. That's another one from, I believe, Brighton. I'm not 100% sure. But long exposure. I'm looking at the 228 seconds, and this is really the sort of photography that I want to start doing in the not too distant future, if possible. I love that sort of thing, just the color, the light, the composition, the whole nine yards. Another one from, sorry, Danny, I don't know where that one's from. I'm trying to read the metadata when it's blacked out. But again, really good lighting. Fantastic color palette. I think that Danny has such a consistent style that's really quite inspiring. And this one is just brilliant as well. The a lightning storm over a city, just fantastic. I'm really really impressed. And then lately, I've gone through a bit of a slump with photography. I've been too busy consulting to get out there and take photos. But it's whenever I sort of go on and see these guys work, it really kind of inspires me to get out there and try to replicate that shot. Or it's good to be inspired, like Trey was saying. So again, that works by Danny Zero, and you can circle him on Google Plus or find him on Facebook. I think his friend requests on Facebook are maxed out, but in either case, check out his work. It's really great.
Hey, how did you do that super zoom? That was super cool.
Oh, right, that. I was on the, I'm using a magic mouse, so I just double tapped. You should be able to do it on your trackpad with a two-finger tap to zoom in.
Two-finger tap. Whoa, that's cool.
I taught Trey Ratcliffe something. How about that? All right, and I'll do the microphone switch. Back to you, Trey.
Okay. Let's see if Catherine is back with us. Hey, Catherine, are you there?
Yeah, can you guys hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yay, happiness and bliss.
Cool. Did you want to show us something with your app before you show us your discovery?
Yeah, I'll make it quick. So the reason I came up with this was I was very reluctant to get model releases when I first started shooting, and I didn't because it was easier to not deal with it. And then that definitely there were a lot of repercussions to that, and I write about it on the website topmodelrelease.com. I won't get into it. But anyway, the whole goal is to make it so that it's easier to get releases, it's easier to organize them, keep them safe, stored, etc. And with a UI that's really fluid and really simple and doesn't take a lot of time. So right now it's out for the iPhone, and we are working on it for the iPad. But this is sort of what it looks like. You can go in, you can create custom releases, and it's really simple. You can see on the top bar, there's just three steps. You get all the information from the shoot. You shoot a picture of the model, so you have a reference photo to go with the release, which is a huge, huge advantage. And then you just review it, and you have them sign. And you can look at the summary page at any time, which is on the far right, to kind of see where you are.
How do they sign? Just right there in the app?
Yeah, they sign right there in the app. And I actually had an attorney because I was nervous about, because I'm very anal myself as a photographer and knowing that the releases are valid. So this has been all approved by the top copyright lawyer, copyright lawyer, Burt Krajes, and also by Getty Images.
Mm.
And it's just like credit cards and everything else. Like digital signatures are becoming a way of, it's just the way of the future. So they just sign and you can get there's a summary of all the releases, and then it generates this PDF, which you can see here. Yeah, it's great. And you can put in your logo, your address. And I mean, the thing is that there's so many things that it really is born from what I wish I had as a photographer, and encouraging photographers to get releases, because I know a lot of people don't, and they think they don't need them. And then what happens is you never know. It could be for entering a contest. It could be someone sees your photo on Google Plus and wants to use it for something. You know, it's not only applicable to professionals. So just getting into the habit of getting a release. And one other thing I really love to mention from an educational tip is that it's really daunting to use Getty releases and other releases that have text that is very overwhelming, such as we can do anything, we can share, we can defame you, we can do this, that, and the other. And a lot of times the really detailed releases are actually more, they protect you less than just a simple release. So one of the things that Bert Krajes says, the copyright lawyer, is it's better just to have a very, very simple release. And what I do, as you noticed in my the release form, is you can create custom releases. And mine is, what I use is typically just two sentences, which is, hey, I was photographed by Catherine Hall on this date, and she may use my image, publish my images in any way, shape, or form, or, you know, that's not the exact legal text. But point being is that you don't have to give them this, like, crazy release that's tons of paragraphs and has a lot of legal language. You can really just keep it simple, and that makes it a lot less intimidating for people to sign, and also, more than anything, a lot less intimidating for you to ask people to sign. So you're more likely to do it. So.
Cool. Thanks for making that. Apps are hard as hell to make, aren't they?
Oh my God. So hard. So much harder than I ever dreamed it would be.
I'll just make a little model release app. It'll be so easy. It'll take a few weeks. But it's hard as hell, isn't it?
Oh my gosh. I feel like, and the thing is that you don't really, I mean, I got tips along the way, but until you do it yourself, you don't really get it. It's kind of like going to Burning Man, Trey.
That's right. That's right. Except Burning Man is more fun. Yeah, so, you know, everyone should go buy it. If you ever, you know, if you even vaguely know of anyone on the internet that produces an app, like, you know, you kind of follow Karen or Catherine or whatever, just go buy it. It's only $4.99. And I know firsthand how hard these apps are to make. And, you know, I know you sit there wondering, oh, $1.99, $2.99, who cares? Just pay $4.99. And get the dang thing, because it's a ton of work, and I know she put a lot of resources and time and effort into it. It's a really hard thing to do, so don't even question. Just go buy a lot of apps and support your local internet person like Catherine, so she can keep doing interesting things.
Yeah.
Lotus is buying it right now.
You never know. Operators are standing by. You never know when you're going to be somewhere. Seriously, they are. Anyway, you never know when you're going to be somewhere and shoot somebody that you weren't expecting to, because I don't usually shoot people, but it happens. And then just be able to really quickly do it.
Well, yeah. No, that's the thing, is the accessibility. And then also for me, you know, especially if I'm traveling, and this, by the way, there's 13 languages on the app, so you can, you know, you can be in a different country and actually have it translated for you.
Wow.
But you can be traveling, and for me it was like, you know, these releases become gold, and I'm in Cuba or somewhere where I don't have access to a scanner, I don't have access to anything to copy these. And so to be able to email it and know it's safe and have the photo attached to it, and there's just a lot of little things that make it just so much better than paper.
Do you need cell signal at that moment when you're using that, or is it all on the phone?
Well, it does sync with iCloud, and it will email out as soon as you get to cell phone, but it's not going to duplicate until you connect again. So basically what will happen is it will store in your outbox, and then once you connect again, it will send. So,
cool.
Yeah. Right. So, but anyway, yeah, you're right, Trey. It's a lot of work. And it is for only iPhone right now. That is our insult, is that we are not on the iPad. If that's the most negative thing people can say, that's wonderful for
me. Don't worry, no. The iPad people complain a little bit. The people you'll really get the vitriol from is the Android people. The Android people,
yeah.
Your lunch.
Yeah.
They're currently quietly cursing you now as some sort of Apple elitist, Catherine.
I know. But anyhow, all right. Well, thank you for letting me share that. I appreciate it.
Sure. Before we go to Karen with her final discovery for us, do you want to plug Twit Photo for tomorrow?
Yeah. Oh, thank you for mentioning that. We have a really, I'm going to take it off screen to share. We have a really special episode tomorrow, probably the one I'm most excited for. We have Mary Ellen Mark. We have a, well, we went to Nordic Light Festival and we got three interviews. And the people on the show tomorrow are Greg Gorman, Robert Pledge, and Mary Ellen Mark, which are all huge icons. They're all in one show. And it's in Norway in three different environments. So it doesn't really get a whole lot better than that. So I'm really, really, really excited for tomorrow's show. You check it out.
Cool. And you were sharing your discovery there. So go ahead and finish that up. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, no worries. So we have today G. Dan Mitchell. And he does a lot of landscape work, as you can see. Beautiful imagery, great use of color, great use of black and white, perspective, composition. And just quite inspiring work. So, I mean, just really a great sense of composition, light, color, depth.
Yeah, I've enjoyed his work in the past.
Yeah, it's just really incredible.
Really nice.
He's very graphic. And it's interesting when you're taking organic objects and seeing them. I mean, these are not organic, obviously, being structures. But whether he's photographing in landscapes or nature, he has this sort of sense of very, you know, using lines very well and perspective and composition and showing these really graphic kind of simplified forms. So I really enjoy his work, and I love how there's that parallel between whether it's man-made or found in nature.
Oh, excellent. Thank you, Catherine. And Karen.
Yes. Okay.
Bring up the rear, so to speak.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for that, Trey. Thanks for pointing that out. That's even
sure.
Special. Yeah, anytime, right? Well, I have a find that was actually shared with me by Ron Clifford from our show Life Through the Lens, because I was didn't have one, and I called him and I said, who do you have? And he said, Ian Thomas. And now I'm like, he's my new favorite for two reasons. Ian Thomas is a twofer. He does these little wire things. So like being held up, the lemons being held up. You can see this, right?
Yes.
Okay. And then we have our ninja sushi. And we have the eggs sneaking out of the fridge in the middle of the night, because they do that. You know they do that. So he's gotten a picture of it. And we've got, so he does all this sort of stuff, right? And I absolutely, it just cracks me up. So my whimsical side is purely delighted, and I can't thank Ron enough for sharing this. But the fun doesn't stop there, because Ian Thomas also does this kind of stuff. Same photographer. Okay, I'm just saying. Love the architect, well, just, I don't know, I just love everything about it, just his sense of, I don't know, art and whimsy and the shapes and the architect. I mean, this could be like four different photographers. So Ian Thomas is my new G+ discovery favorite inspiration. Look, that's a twofer. He got those two images right there. And there you have it.
That one.
Did you?
I love that.
I took it off the screen. This one?
Yeah, the one you just had up with the dandelion seeds and the water droplets. That kind of stuff gets me. Love it.
Yep.
Just go down. Sorry, I'm talking through Trey's microphone right now, but can you just go back to that big list? And
that big
and,
what?
The glass on fire. What's the glass on fire? Down?
Down, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, isn't this neat?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, here I go. Wait, now you can't go backwards. Sorry. Spasmatron. All right.
You can use right and left arrow.
Yeah, I'm nervous now. Don't tell me what to do. Trey, God, don't tell me what to do.
That's excellent. I mean, I'm a pyromaniac, as you may have gathered from some of my stuff, but I love that sort of thing. That's excellent.
Isn't that neat? It's like,
very cool.
Yeah, it's like you meets Alex meets superhero meets, I don't know. It makes my little brain go, oh, I like it. I don't understand it, but I like it.
Yeah, that's one of the good things about living near the country is you can always be sure that there's plenty of fire to play with and photograph. It's great.
Oh my God, I hadn't seen this one. Look at these two meet. There's a helicopter in the middle.
That's cool.
That is really crazy.
That guy's good.
He's good. He's really good. So that is Ian Thomas.
Okay, well, thank you, Karen, and thank you, everybody. Thank you, Eden, for letting me crash your place here. It's wonderful. Everything's going great. There's his Eden thumb. anyway, it was a great show. I hope everyone learned something, had a good time. We all had a great time at the photo walks in San Francisco. Maybe there'll be another one next year. Nobody knows, but I hope so. Yes, there should be, shouldn't there?
Yeah.
Cool.
So
all right.
So open invitation. Should anyone want to come visit Queenstown? If anyone's traveling the world and wants to come see me and Trey, then you're more than welcome here.
Well, don't include me on that. Just a minute. I got to go find a house first. That's my task for the rest of the week, is to find a place to live. All right?
Well, you make sure it has a nice guest room.
Yeah, really. Jeez.
Rooms.
It's a guest house on the property.
G-Plus conference at Trey's.
Yeah!
Right there.
Yeah, we'll do it.
Well, you can use my parents' place if his house is available. There you go.
Well, actually, one thing I'm going to do down here, this is a little secret, is I'm going to have I don't do many workshops, but I'm going to do one down here. And usually my workshops are pretty expensive, you know, like we do like maybe a weekend one for it's like maybe $2,000 or something. But I'm going to make it free for all Kiwis. So anyone that, you know, lives here in Queenstown or anywhere in New Zealand, I'll make it, it'll be free. I don't want to, you know, make money off these nice people.
You just want to make money off of us?
Yeah, I don't want to make money off you guys. No, I like the Kiwi people are very nice, and it's kind of my new home, so I want to, there's a lot of people that are very interested in photography here, so I think it'll be a fun way to do it. And also, I know there's a lot of people, I've been watching the questions on chat and in the various streams people have been asking about. At our photo walk, we have a little contest as well. And I'll announce the winner of that tomorrow on the blog, or maybe the next day, depending on when I get time to make to get everything together. I'm having some bandwidth issues down here. I got to get that sorted out. But
what's been the most rewarding part of your move thus far? The most like, aha, this is amazing, I'm here moment.
Well, you know, we're renting a home now in this area called Aspen Grove, which is up on the side of the hill, and we look across the way at these amazing mountains called the Remarkables, and I've always known they're pretty, and I've known there's nice sunrises and sunsets in the middle of the day. But what has really surprised me is that they've never looked the same twice. The light, you know, and, you know, this is sort of this thing, oh, the light is always different, the weather is always different. You know, this is sort of this old thing you march out as a photographer or whatever. But it's here, it's not only a little bit different, it's much different. It's just staggering, the amount of differences I'm seeing. I've seen such variation just in, like, 1 week's time. I can't imagine that I would ever see every possible combination, permutation of light and shadow and snow and rock and grass. It's wild. So I've been really just over. I came with super high expectations, and they've already been exceeded. So, yeah.
Well, it's beautiful there. I'm excited for you.
Yes, we will try to have a big party down here sometime. That'll be nice.
I think you'll end up traveling. People will say you travel less because you're so far away, but now you're going to travel more because you're so far away. So when you get out,
yeah,
you're going to really travel.
yeah. Well, there's a lot of targets right around here, so I won't have to travel quite as much because there's stuff. So I see in the background, Eden pulled up a picture here of Queenstown or of the Remarkables, those mountains I was talking about. And I'll ask him to put a link to that inside the main thread for this so so everyone goes see it full screen.
You'll have to tell me where to put that.
I'll show you where to put it. Don't worry. Okay, everybody, thanks again, and I will see you next week at the same bat time, same bat channel. And we can all kind of just wave goodbye from our little quadrants of space out there. Thanks again, everybody.
Thanks, Trey.
Thanks, Trey.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks, Trey.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.